So now we're doing a video to show you something's going on. This bee ate some of the pollen out of this flower and it's walking around like it's drunk or disoriented, and it's not flying. Usually when these bees have this problem, they don't fly. This bee doesn't have any pollen on it, but it can't seem to find its way. And my guess is it'll do the same thing I've seen happen before, where it'll just die. There's another flower a little further over here, and I'll show you the same thing's happening on this, with this one right here. This bee here is pretty well not moving at all anymore. See? They eat from these flowers, but if you look at the flowers, they don't look very healthy. See that discoloration? Same thing you were seeing in all the leaves that I was showing you. So we'll come back to that one. I'm going to go back to this other bee because it's still moving. And most likely this video is going to catch it dying. It's not very pleasant, but I want you to see what's happening here. Like, this bee is having problem walking. It can't fly. You know, it ate some of this flower. But if you look at the center of the flower and we'll go up close, I'll show you. See how they look? See the discoloration and the funny edges on these, on this stuff? It's the same thing as on the leaves. See, look at this bee. Like, it's really struggling to walk. So I'll do this video for a little while because it's going to be interesting. See, it's not, the bee's not eating any pollen. It's like, it doesn't, it seems like it doesn't know what to do, where it's going. It's not walking very healthy. And since I'm zoomed right in, you can see that it's fumbling and it's tripping. So the other bee that I showed you a second ago on the other flower, it's dead. It's not moving. This is the third video I'm doing. And this one here is really good because it's nice and clear. We get to watch this bee walk around and realize something's not right here. It's like it's lost. Bees don't act like this. This is not natural. It's not lost. It doesn't want any pollen. It already had some or tried to eat some of that flower. So I think it's actually doing pretty good, because the other bees that I've seen, when they do this, they start moving really slow. They just stop moving and just die. Other people have noticed there's something wrong too, but right now I'm going to keep talking. Hopefully, you know, this video won't run more than 10 minutes. It's almost 3 minutes now. So you keep watching this and you tell me if this is normal behavior for a bee. See, it's fumbling and almost falling off. The reason why it's going through this is it can't fly. Something it ate is messing up its nervous system. And it's like I said, the chemtrails in the sky or the radiation from Fukushima. Because last year I never saw anything like this. We've had chemtrails for a while, but we've never had radiation coming down from the sky. You can see what I mean now. You keep watching, you can see. This bee keeps falling over. It's like lost, it's fumbling. But like I said before, usually when a bee gets into trouble, when it lands on a flower, it doesn't last this long. I mean, you know, you and me can figure out this. It's not able to push with his legs properly. Well, I'm going to go back and show you the other one now. It was moving when I first pulled up here. I could see its tentacles were moving. As you can see, that bee is no longer moving. It's like dead. If it wasn't dead, you'd see some kind of life in it. You see it moving, but there's nothing moving. And the other bee, it's probably still... I'm going to zoom back to the other bee when I can see it with my eyes. I don't know what happened to the other bee. It might have fallen off the flower. Okay. It's dead. Explain that to me. Go ahead, tell me. Why are the bees dying when they land on these flowers? I'm gonna go down this plant next to it and show you something. You see all this stuff on the leaves right here? That's not fall colors, folks. There's something falling from the rain that does this to the plants. And this is what these bees are eating, is whatever's on these plants, it's eating it. That's the future of the world, contaminated soil. And the radiation just started falling back last year from Fukushima. And every year that goes by now, the radiation levels in the water in the earth is going to keep going higher and higher, meaning that the radiation is going to get deeper and deeper into the soil. I noticed this year that small trees, when they first sprouted their leaves in spring, they died. And the bigger trees are having problems, they're all discolored. But next year, we're going to have a lot more dead trees than we have now. I'm going to move around and see if I can spot this bee wherever it went, because I can't sit here staring at a flower. It went underneath the flower, and I don't know where it is. Oh, there it is. Bees, when they die on flowers, they can die underneath the flower. They can die anywhere because their little feet have hooks on them. And they, I'm just trying to find where I'm at here. There it is. So when they die, their feet stay hooked. So there's that bee that we were looking at that's in trouble. I'm going to back up a bit more so I can get it clearer. It's just the way cameras work. And the people who look at these flowers, they don't realize that something's wrong with what's happening to the bees. There we go. So we can see pretty clearly this bee here, and it's not moving anymore. It's like I said, when the bees land on the flowers, they start moving really slow, and then they just die. And that bee is underneath that flower, and it's dead. So I'm going to turn off the video. This is a pretty good one. It showed you how this bee landed, started eating, and then it died. So I'm doing another story about the dead bees that land inside the flowers over at the Halifax Public Gardens. So I'm going to zoom into this flower. Taking a still picture wouldn't prove to you that these bees are dead. There's actually two bees in this one. I'm going to show you. Okay, the bees land, they get inside the flowers, and they die. So I'm going to zoom in here. Hopefully I can get this clear. So as you can see, there's two bees in here. They land in the flowers and they die. Like, that doesn't make any sense. You tell me what's going on, folks. So if you watch my other video I did earlier, with all the bees that were in one flower, there, now I'll be able to hold this a lot steadier. Here we go. So you see, you tell me why the bees are dying when they land inside the flowers. So this is a follow-up on the story I did yesterday about the bee dying on the flower. This is the same flower, and this is the next day, and I came over here and I found this flower and I said, okay. And I was looking at it and I noticed that any bee that was landing on this flower was dying. And this is a really big bee, and I've been watching it doing some pictures. You can see the pictures that I have. And you'll see that this bee died while he was eating at this flower. And this is what's happening all over the world with bees and everything. They're all dying, and the Fukushima fallout is killing everything. So you're having a good look at a close-up here. And there we go. Let's see if I can do it. No, can't do it this close. So this time I decided to pull this flower up because every bee that lands on it dies. And here I'm sitting here in a garden holding this big fat bee, and it died right in front of my eyes. And people don't notice anything but I do. Hey, look, the bee died while it was on this flower.
Really?
Yeah, they're all dying. This is happening all over the world. Look at all the trees, everything's dying. It's the Fukushima fallout.
Yeah. Yeah.
You don't touch it.
No.
But it's dead.
Oh, yeah.
Like yesterday I was here, I was doing some pictures, and I did a video of a bee that landed on this, started eating, and it died in front of my camera.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at it.
I see it.
It's barely alive. It's been struggling to move, and I've been taking pictures of it, but it's finally completely dead. But this time I decided to remove the flower because this flower has been killing all the bees. Okay, I'm going to finish this video that I was doing, showing you all the bees that are dying on when they touch these flowers. So you see the one in my hand? As you know, what I was doing earlier, it died. But I'm going to zoom into the bush in front of me, and you're going to see everywhere on that bush, there's bees and all the flowers, and they're all dead. So here we go. I'm going to show you. So I'm going to zoom. There's one here. Oh, I'm a little too close. I'm going to back up so you can get it clear. Okay. Let me show you all the flowers that are here, okay? And you're going to see there's dead bees in all of them. The bees hit these flowers and they start going really slow and they can't move. So there's one there. There's probably one in every one of them. There's one there. There. And see, let's keep going. Look, see all the flowers have these bees. They hit these flowers and the bees all of a sudden slow down and they can't fly. And over a period of time, I watched them and they die. Looks like this one right in front of me. As you can see right here, I'm going to zoom back out. So people who tell you the bees aren't dying, well, they better pay attention, man. There's a reason why this is happening. And like I was saying to you before, this is all the Fukushima fallout, the radiation, the plutonium that's coming down from Fukushima. And it's killing everything. The trees in Halifax are really in pitiful condition. There's dead, look at that, look at all the dead bees everywhere on there. This is happening everywhere.
Wood.
It's for real. They're all dying. You know, all these... Okay, another look over Halifax after 4 days of really, really heavy rain. Today, September the... Hold on, folks. September the 24th, 2012 in Halifax. So now I'm going to show you how much worse these trees are. And if you look at my previous videos, you will see. But one thing, I don't know if you can tell on this camera, but the color of the trees is really, really bad. So I'll start right here. And I'm doing this video for reference, so you can see the condition of these trees. Like that one's completely dead now. These ones down here. Look. They're all dead now, see? But if you look at my video even a month ago, these trees weren't dead. And this is not fall, folks. Fall hasn't even started here. I did this one on my video, and this one's lost half its branches now. And I'll zoom right in up close so you can have a good look at the condition of these branches. See if I can hold this steady enough for you. So as you can see, they're still green in the tree, so it's not fall, because when fall happens, the sap starts flowing and all the leaves turn at the same time. So none of these trees have proper colors. So we're gonna start way over here and we're gonna zoom in so you can have a look at the color of all these trees and all the dead trees. It's everywhere. But people don't see anything because they don't look up. They don't look at the trees. I'm trying to get the camera to focus. Okay, it's focused now. People walk around and they see all these leaves falling off the trees all summer long and they think nothing of it. They don't realize trees don't lose their leaves in the summer. Look at all the dead trees here. It's everywhere. There's not one tree that you can see that has proper green colors in it. So, are you getting the idea just how horrible this is? Look, just colored dead trees everywhere. Look at the horrible colors of these trees. They're not even green. And the ones that look green are kind of yellow in them. They're too bright. Look, I'm going to take my time so you can see how bad this is. It's getting late now in the daytime. It's like getting dark. The sun's going down, but it makes for a very good time to do videos because people don't realize if you do the videos when it's sunny out, you don't get the contrast. You don't get the colors. Let's see if we can zoom in really far here, just towards Spryfield. Can't tell from here. I'm taking my time so you can compare this video to the ones that I've done earlier. Look at these trees along here. Everything's dying. It's not fall, folks. Like I said, fall hasn't even begun yet. To get fall, you got to have really cold weather. You got to have cold nights that tells the trees to stop growing sap. The people that clear trees, boy, they're going to be some busy next year with people calling them saying, all my trees are dead and you need to cut them down. The city's going to have a huge expense of cutting down dead trees. Now you see how bad this is? I can understand when people are on the ground, they don't look up and they don't see how bad the trees are. But when you're up high like this, you really see it. And every time I look out my window, it's really, really depressing to watch all the trees dying. I never thought this would ever happen in my lifetime. And the worst thing is people, you know, that I've talked to on the street, some know something's wrong. They're noticing the trees aren't looking healthy everywhere they go. But some people say it's because of chemtrails. But we've had chemtrails for years, and last year the trees didn't look like this. The only thing that's changed from last year is all the radiation falling out from Fukushima. See all these colors? Like, look at these greens. They're not even green. They're like they got like a grayish look to them. And if you go to the link below this video, you're going to see pictures that I've been doing. Showing now we have a new problem I discovered this week is all the tree trunks of the trees are all turning like a pale green, like a looks like a moss on the trees, but it's not moss because it's happening on all the sides of the tree, and it's happening in trees that aren't even in the shade. So that grayish look you're looking at on all the trees is being deposited on the tree trunks too. But remember, this isn't just happening to trees, this is happening to all the foliage. So now you're getting a really good look at how horrible the condition of the trees is. So for you people that are doing research, I hope you enjoy my videos. Look at the color of these trees. It's not even green. It's not because of lighting. They've all got a pale green color to them. Everything's dying. I'm so depressed about watching all of this. I'll try to hold it really steady here and I'll zoom into these leaves so you can get an idea up close. If the camera can focus that far away. That's like 140 times zoom here. Okay, back up a bit. So you can get a bearing on where I'm at. Should be calling your governments up and the media up and ask them to do a story about this and let everybody know what the hell's going on with all the trees. Everywhere you look, it is not a healthy tree in sight. If there was fall colors, you wouldn't have this coloration on different leaves and another one still being green. That's not how trees go into fall. But if you look at all these trees, all the leaves have a gold edge to them. See all that? It's like rust color. That's not fall and that's not a heat wave. We don't get heat waves in Halifax. We're too far north and we got ocean all around us. There's no shortage of water here. It's not about drought. It's not fall colors. I'm repeating all this stuff because I've heard read comments under my videos saying, one guy said fall colors. This isn't fall. It's not even fall yet here. It's still summertime. See? Next year we're going to be in trouble, but next year it's going to be too late. It's already too late anyway. People to next year are going to wake up and say, why don't the trees have leaves on them? Look at these ones. If you look at my pictures earlier in the summer, there was leaves on these trees and they all died. Look. Everywhere. Look. Dead trees everywhere. And next year it's going to be a lot worse. Even the red leaves aren't supposed to be red. Different trees react differently to the chemtrails. You go up close and you realize that's not, it's not fall colors. I can't believe people think that this is fall. This is only September. And we don't get fall here until the end of October, even later. Has to have really cold nights before the trees start losing their leaves. See how the tops of the trees have got the golden color and then underneath it's green? That's because of chemtrails. Everywhere you look. Oh, I guess the people that are doing the chemtrailing and their geoengineering, they've finally done it, eh? And if you think this isn't affecting your health, you're probably noticing everybody you talk to these days not feeling very well, their spirits not high, they're having problems breathing. Remember this one that had leaves on it earlier? They were all falling off and the tree died. Yeah, my landlord came over and tried to block my window from opening so I can stick my camera out. Nobody's gonna fall out this window. I got a balcony. Anybody's gonna fall out off of anything. Balcony, that means you would have to close my patio door. But I don't go on my balcony to do videos because I can't stand very well because I'm disabled pretty bad. So I have to lean on this window ledge to be able to do this. I'm going to pan out again so you can see where I'm at, so you can refer to my other videos, so you can take stills from these videos online, eh? You're free to copy these videos and pass them around and do whatever you want to show people. There's no copyright on these, just let them know where it came from, where you got the video from. See? As far as the eye can see, all I see is dead trees everywhere, and it's never been like this before, ever, ever, ever. Sick and dying trees everywhere. So now I'm gonna end this video and I'm gonna go out on my balcony and do the other side a little bit more if I can. Well, maybe I'll do my dining room window, I don't know. Please share this with everybody and wake up and go to Chemtrails, Chemtrails site, which is called chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com. Thank you. Bye. Okay, we're at the Halifax Public Gardens. It's September 17th, 2012. To people who are not observant, which is most people, everything looks pretty beautiful here. And now I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to show you this fall. This is a follow-up video of the condition of the trees. So when we zoom in, I'll zoom right in really close. And you look right up close to the leaves, you look, they're all burnt, discolored. And what I want you to see in this video is there's not one tree here that has beautiful green natural colors. They're all different shades of kind of like a pale looking green. They're all different colors. That fallout from Fukushima is doing this all over the world. And people aren't noticing. All the trees are dying. They're all unnatural colors. They've all got that burnt. If you look on top of this tree here, for example, the leaves are all burnt. This is not from a heat wave. We're up in Halifax here in Nova Scotia. And we really don't get heat waves here. And some people might say, oh, it's a drought. There's no drought problem either. We get enough rain. And you get all different shades of trees, and this is not the way they're supposed to look. I have other videos and pictures that I've done over the years here, the same time of the year. So, like this tree is not even green. It's like got like a gray. The other trees have got it. They look yellow from a distance, but when you go up close to them, as I'm doing right now, you go really close and you look at the leaves and you go, wow, look at that. They're all burnt. Or they're discolored on the edges. I wonder what condition these, what's going to happen next year, because all these trees are dead this year. Next year there won't even be any leaves on them. If you look at the other videos that I've done, you know by now that this is for real. Everything's dying. Look at this. I'm an older guy, and it's really amazing that we live in a society full of stupid people that don't have a clue to look at anything. They come over here to look at the trees, but they don't see there's not one healthy tree that they're looking at. How can you admire nature when nature is wounded like this? So when I posted my pictures online of all the burnt and damaged trees everywhere, I get reports, and this is happening all over the world. In Germany, BC, Southern USA, everywhere. Everybody that's been leaving comments is saying they have the same problem. Through the USA, they're claiming there's 80% of the USA is in a state of emergency because there's no food growing. And they're saying it's a drought. It's not a drought. The people are being told that, so they will think, well, that's why the leaves are brown or this and that. This happens and gets worse after every rainfall. I just hope that you, when you walk around your neighborhood, you start looking at all the trees and look at all the plants. It's not just the trees this is happening to. Like, you look on the ground right in front of me. This is like September. There's not supposed to be any leaves on the ground. They've been on the ground falling off trees all summer long. But do you think people ever look up at the tree to figure out why are all the leaves falling off? And if they were to look up at the tree like we're going to do right now, take a look at what you see. Look at that. All the leaves are all black. They're all diseased. And it's not a disease from the plant. It's from the air, the rain. That wasn't a good example. See if I can get a spot where there's a good one. So what do you see? Yellow leaves, brown leaves, but if you notice, they're curled up. If this was due to fall or even a drought, the leaves wouldn't curl up like that. If it's fall, all the leaves change color at the same time, but they never curl up. That's the tree that's right above me. Look at the leaves. They're all full of holes. I mean, everything. Everywhere you look, when you start looking up close, you're noticing everything's dying. When I was young and I kept telling people, man, those nuclear reactors are creating nuclear waste that nobody can get rid of. And you get all these time bombs all over the world. Now they're paying the price. Look at this tree. It's like yellow instead of red. I mean, sorry, instead of green. Even this one, look at the colors on this. It's not even green. Everywhere you look. You have to actually look to see what's happening. Look, this is what the rain does. This is an acid rain, folks. This is radiation. It's giving a lot of leaves a reddish look. Every plant's getting affected in a different way, depending on the species. So here's that tree that I was talking about, and look at it. It's all, the leaves are all yellow, and this is not fall. because there are green leaves in there. So I'll try to give you another example here. Let's see if I can find a spot where I can zoom in so you can see what's really happening. There we go. Now, let's see if the camera will focus. Now, if it was fall, you wouldn't have yellow leaves, brown leaves, black leaves, and green leaves. Fall hasn't even started here, and it doesn't start for another month, maybe another month and a half. So now, I'll look around this side. This big tree here, it's almost all dead. Like, all the leaves are really poor and thin, and this is the Halifax Public Gardens that has the best maintenance for trees and gardens and anywhere in Canada. So let's see, what else can I show you? Unless you go up close to the trees, you're not gonna see what's wrong with them. I'm rolling around in a wheelchair in case you're wondering what's going on here. Okay, I'm gonna give you an example of the burnt trees. Here we've got a tree that's all yellow back here. That's not supposed to be yellow. It's supposed to be green. But if you look at this one right here, see all the discolored leaves? Okay, let's go to a spot that's not moving as much. There we go. If you look up close, you see, this is not natural. All the edges of the leaves are all curled up and all black and red and burnt. But like I said when I started this video, most people are not observant. They don't have a clue what even goes on outside their house, let alone in the trees and everything else. But I'm gonna go down this path a little ways, and I want to show you something else.
Some of the grass is back there.
Yeah. Okay, actually, I'm gonna start here. At a distance, the tree looks healthy, and you looked up close, and what do you see? All the leaves are dying, look. Let's see if the camera will focus on this. But I'm going to show you something else a little further down. It's not just the trees this is happening to. This is happening to all the foliage. Flowers, plants, everything. Now up here, there's plants that are really damaged from the fallout from the rain. And here we go. So when you zoom in and you take a good look at these plants, you'll see what the rain's doing to them. There you go. Look at this. You gotta get the camera to focus. And what do you see? See the end of the leaves are all burnt, then there's yellow and there's green. That's not how plants go into fall. And we'll do this one now. See? So you've got green ones, and then you got these other ones that are dying. The rain does this. I have pictures of this plant up close, so you can see what's going on. So now I'm looking at how much time I've got on my video. I don't want to make this video too long. We're at 10 minutes already. It's a fairly long video already. Okay, I'm gonna rush over to another part. I'm gonna show you another plant that's really, really been damaged by what's coming out of the rain. I mean, it doesn't matter where you go. Look, I can come up close here and you can look at this. And people think that this is natural, okay? Yellow, reds, all these colors. There's nothing natural about this, folks. And all the trees, I don't have to describe it. They don't have a deep blue, there I go, a deep green, beautiful, healthy color. None of these trees do. But what's really horrific about this is finding out when I posted my pictures online that this is happening all over the world. So when you look around, you see yellow trees, you see gold trees. They're supposed to be green. So now I'm going to show you something else. Besides the fact that this tree back here is all yellow and unhealthy, if you look up close, you realize it's not yellow, it's actually gold. And if you keep going closer, you look at the leaves and you go, look at that. This is completely unnatural. This is not from fall. This is still summertime here. Okay, so you see from a distance it looks yellow, but people aren't even noticing what's wrong with the plants. But I'm going to show you this one. The top looks really fairly healthy. And then you go down and you wonder and you go, wow, what happened here? Like, why is all this curled up and black and dying? Look at this. Look at the condition of this thing. See? And this is the Halifax Public Gardens, and never, ever, ever have they had plants do this. This isn't just happening to the foliage, it's happening to the flowers. And the more you look around, the more you realize this is happening everywhere. But remember, so a lot of this foliage you see grows very quickly, so the rain can fall, and then the foliage is replaced with new foliage. But you look around here, look at the colors. It's not my camera, look. They don't have a green color to them. It's kind of like yellow. Trees aren't supposed to be yellow. And that one right there, it's like half dead already. All the leaves die and they fall off and people think that's natural. A lot of the trees in this park have been here for hundreds and hundreds of years, but never, ever have we had a problem like this before. So this is not acid rain, folks. This is Fukushima, is what I'm guessing. It's Fukushima rain in with the chemtrails material. So I think the chemtrails material is bonding to the radiation. And we'll go over here. Now these cactuses are, I don't know how old they are, they're very old, but they don't grow outdoors. They only bring them out of the greenhouse in the spring and plant them here. But if you look at my pictures from last year, you'll see that they didn't have all this damage on the skin. See that? See all that? That's all from the rain. But it's like I said about all the different plants. If you don't look up close, you're not going to see. You're not going to see anything. Look at it, like, this is not natural. Now it's time for me to do a second video of the condition of the trees outside my window in Halifax, which is really pitiful, but this is everywhere in Halifax. And it's now September, I believe, the 7th today. So we're still like a month away before the trees are supposed to start turning color. And I'll just do a scan around and show you. We'll start back with this one down here. And the colors on this tree are really terrible. And the leaves are in really poor condition, as you can see. And this is not from fall. And there's, a lot of these trees that have yellow leaves everywhere, just colored leaves. There's the next tree over to it. So something really bad is happening. Trees are all dying. And like usual, the sheeple are too stupid to pay attention to anything. They walk around, they look at all the sick trees everywhere, and nobody talks about it. How did the people become so stupid not to notice that even their own environment is under attack? Look at all the leaves all over the ground. This is like summertime. And there's leaves falling everywhere. And it would look like that they're falling because it's fall, but it's not. Because if you look, a lot of these leaves are full of green. And leaves don't fall when they're off trees when they're green. in fall, they turn yellow and then they then fall off. Like these here, that's not from fall though. Because the tree, most of the tree is green, and that's not how trees change. When the sap stops flowing because of cold weather, the whole tree changes color at the same time, and that's how it works. And this is not what's happening here. See the yellow spots everywhere in these trees? All this colored, all these colors are wrong. Like the greens aren't even green. They're like a black green, there's yellows. See, look at all the discolored leaves. And that's not from fall, because if it was in fall, there wouldn't be any green leaves. They would all be discolored evenly. You know, different colors in one tree. See, this tree never came back to life. This one now, you saw it last time, and now you can see it's like really finished. So we get yellow leaves. This tree's really bad off. Look at all the colors on this tree. Look at the yellows on this tree. It's all burnt. Radiation or whatever is doing it. Chemtrails. Doesn't really matter, the world's gone insane. People don't care, give a damn about polluting the environment, but it's the real problem in this world is a corrupt corporate state. How everything works on a corporation is a crime syndicate. Corporations are structured as crime syndicates. This one's really hurting bad. There's a lot of these around Halifax. I was going around yesterday and talking to people. And people are in denial, but they can't help but notice that there's trees that are diseased and sick everywhere. These leaves have been falling off that tree all summer long, like for the last 2 months. But everywhere you look, all the trees, the leaves, the edges of the leaves are all discolored. This has never happened before. This is not the way nature looks. Look at the poor colors of all these trees. But better yet, you know, I mean, I'm doing it on video, but go outside and go look at the trees for a change, guys. Go up to your neighborhood skyscraper or tall building and, you know, look down like I'm doing at all the trees in your town, in your city. I had one guy from the USA, when I posted this video on his blog, he sent me a link to a video that he did, showing that where he lives, all the forests look like this. And this is somewhere far away on the other side of the US. And I've had a woman tell me in BC that they're having the same thing there, British Columbia. And so far, I'm getting reports that it's happening the same all over North America. Look at the condition of these trees. And people aren't concerned. All the trees are dying. Well, it's pretty pitiful, you know, that people aren't speaking up and aren't asking the government and everybody in the media to do a story. But our media, we don't have a media anymore. We have idiots living off the glory of all the money that the media has and all the fancy cameras. And doesn't matter how fancy the cameras are. We don't have a media anymore. It doesn't report any kind of truth whatsoever. It doesn't have a clue what truth is. It fabricates its own stories. It actually has actors acting out in front of the cameras doing interviews for whatever the story they're doing. I learned that when I was covering the Occupy movement and saw the media bringing in their own actors and faking everything. So, see, everywhere you look, remember these trees, okay, they aren't green, okay, they're not, their colors are all off. This is not proper green. This is like everywhere you look. I doubt very much that next spring there's going to be any of these trees that are going to still be showing leaves. All these trees have discolored.
And you've got the burnt yellow, rust color. Everywhere you look. That's really far away and it's kind of hazy. You got early morning right now. I'm doing this before the sun comes out. Because the only way to get the contrast and be able to see the trees is to do it when there's no sun out, because the sun causes so much shadows on the trees that you can't see what you're looking at when it comes to the leaves. All the leaves cause shadows, and so if you want to do this in your neighborhood, make sure it's overcast. See? Everywhere you look. I can't do it way up there because it's too early in the morning and too much haze. And you can see I've got quite the view from where I live, and this is why I noticed this back in June. I said something's really wrong, all the trees are sick. So I may be the only one that's ever done a high view like this over a city with a camera to show people what's happening. Remember guys, this is not fall colors. This is not natural at all. It will be fall colors in another month or so, maybe a little longer than that. It takes a good cold night before the sap stops flowing in trees and the trees start going dormant for the winter. It depends which part of the world you live in, but here in Canada, in Nova Scotia, as you know, trees turn color and we lose them in the spring. They come back in the spring. So, are you seeing enough dead trees everywhere yet? You know, can you believe that that people actually are destroying this planet? They'll do anything for greed. Their corporate image, their fake image. They, you know, they live the act. They act out their lives. They go to get the fancy car and the fancy house. Anything for self-gratification and the destruction of the environment and everything that's natural and beautiful, whether it be natural human nature or everything else, they don't care. The world is so sick today. Anyway, I just wanted to do a quick one because I'm getting tired of doing this. Oh, wait a second, we'll go on this side. We'll just give you a little bit more here. They look healthy until you go up close and look at them. So then when you walk around, you can go up close and look at the trees. See? Well, they all look like they're burnt from radiation or something like that. But go have a look at the branches or look at my pictures and look at the link below this video. And you'll see close-ups of all these, what these leaves look like. See? It's like that everywhere. Everything's dying. Yep. Some people are depopulating the world. They think there's too many people. Possibly there's too many destructive people. But I myself say the real problem is when they introduced corporatism to the world. The greedy bastards that loved making money at the expense of the environment and everybody else. And the military-industrial complex that's chemtrailing the skies and geoengineering the control the weather and environmental warfare. The list of insanity doesn't end, and that's the problem. The reason why all this insanity is happening in the world is because people refuse to believe that anything like that could be happening, and they don't go and check to see if it is happening. And because they think, well, there's no way can people be that crazy, be doing all that stuff, so nobody checks it out for themselves. And as long as you don't check out things for yourself, and you don't speak up like I'm doing here, then the insane are going to keep doing more and more insane things until they just finally just completely destroy things. And you'll wonder why one day, why is the earth dying? Why are the trees dying? It's because you never spoke up. You've got just as much power in this world as anyone else just by speaking up. You know, tell your neighbors, man, we don't want chemtrails in our skies, but do you speak up? No. You don't think chemtrails are real.